The first year, after orientation, I had a sense that everyone was very laid back, down to earth, so I had really good expectations going into the year. I also thought that the work would be manageable. I mean, I knew med school was difficult, but I mean, how difficult could it be? We got this far, we got into medical school. And one thing that surprised me was the workload, the amount of information that we had to learn, and how little time we had to learn it all. But one thing that didn't change was how down to earth everybody was, how helpful. Groups started to form where people would split up work, help each other out, and even if you didn't have information to share, it was just sharing words of like comfort, words of encouragement, and it was very nice to have that group of people. And I tell my parents all the time, it's like having a second family. It's like you have your love-hate moments. Like some days you just get so frustrated being in the same room with the same 65 people, but then at the end of the day, you just realize when you get those emails from everyone and words of encouragement that we really are like a little family here, and we also have a lot of support from the faculty and the staff. But one of my favorite moments of the school year, I think the majority of the class doesn't know this, but at Melissa's ugly sweater party, I was sitting on top of the hot tub and I fell into the hot tub like a turtle. My feet were in the air and the lid caved in around me and smushed me in, and I couldn't get out on my own. I actually forget who pulled me out because I was so embarrassed. I didn't even make eye contact and I walked away, but that would be my confession moment, just sitting on top of that hot tub while everybody else is in the other room and falling in. That was definitely an experience and a very memorable moment. And it's enough time has passed now that I could share that embarrassing moment with the rest of the class. And thank you, whoever pulled me out.
Did you go underneath the water?
No.
Oh,
it was empty, but because it was empty, you know how like the lid, they're kind of like they fold over? It folded on. I couldn't get out. I'm like, help me. And I don't know who pulled me out, but I was so embarrassed. I didn't even look at them.
And now, WBIA President Bill Kelly.
Well, good evening, everyone. Welcome to State of Pennsylvania. It was just a couple of years ago, not a few people in this area were doubters. They simply couldn't imagine a medical school in Scranton. Why here? Who could possibly make it happen? Where would the money come from? And if they built it, would anybody come? Well, now the money's been raised, the buildings are going up, and best of all, most exciting of all, there are students, future doctors, attending classes at the new Commonwealth Medical College every day. What they do in those classrooms is so unique, many chose Scranton over established university med schools in major cities. She was so much wanted to do this, she had her hands up and waving. Not really, no, not really.
Not quite.
Not at all. Tell us who you are.
My name is Jennifer Sidari. I was born and raised in West Pittston, so I'm a local. I went to Wyoming area for high school and the University of Scranton for undergrad, so I went to school with John and Meg, who have you met already.
Tell us what this means to you, the Commonwealth Medical College.
Means the world. I'm 100% a product of this area. The hard work and dedication of so many people, so many teachers, elementary school, high school, in undergrad. So it means the world to me to be able to be here and eventually give back.
How nice. What kind of doctor do you think you want to be? Do you know yet?
No idea.
Is it hard?
Yes, it's very hard to make this decision. Our community experience weeks, as many people have talked about already, we get to shadow so many different specialties, and it's really hard to pick just one.
I guess what I was asking you, is the curriculum hard?
Oh, is the curriculum hard? It's med school. Really? Of course it's hard. Not fun. That's
you're doing a great. You're doing a great interview for somebody who didn't want to do this. You're doing a great interview.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
This West Pittston neighborhood is holding strong in the sight of such heartache.
I went to the neighbors. I said, "Look, we've been under a lot of stress. We've all been going crazy. Let's just sit down and relax tonight."
The Montgomery Avenue times are tough, but we're tougher block party. pizza, some beverages, and smiles, something even FEMA took note of.
I see, you know, the community coming together, you know, and celebrating life here.
In the midst of incredible challenges, torn up houses, upended decks, and fast-paced mold, the people of this block hold on to hope.
It's amazing how you can lose so much and still feel so blessed because the people have been absolutely amazing.
From the street sweeper on Mud Patrol to the American Red Cross, they're greeted with gratitude and smiles. Helping hands from Congressman Lou Barletta's office pitched in to help Bernadette Nudie, shoveling heavy mud out of her basement.
I was just so grateful. They came. I called and somebody came.
Inside the Sidari family's home, everything is pretty much gutted.
It's upsetting, but it also, it like starts on a new set of memories that we could make and create and live on. So we're trying to hang in there the best as we can.
New memories from a time of 12 and 15 hour long days of back-breaking work when neighbors stopped to share how they're overcoming the flood of 2011.
You never expect anything like this. You never plan for something like this, and it's really hard to be prepared for something like this.
And the first Doctor of Medicine degrees in the history of the college to its charter class.
It's a very exciting day, not only for myself, but for all my classmates and the entire community. It's been a long journey.
The journey began in August 2009 when the Commonwealth Medical College welcomed its first class of medical degree students. Now, almost 4 years later, those future doctors are accepting their diplomas.
It's been quite an experience. I mean, I'm definitely a very different person today than I was when I began.
57 students graduated from TCMC with their medical degrees, becoming the region's first locally trained doctors.
So many of them who are from this region have said that as soon as they're done with their training, they're going to come right back here to practice.
My parents have a very obnoxious 6-foot banner hanging on our front porch in West Pittston.
Jennifer Sidari plans to stick to her roots. She's beginning a residency in pediatrics at Geisinger Health System.
Love kids. There's just something about working with kids that at the end of the day, it is challenging, but it leaves you with an energy.
These students, who call themselves guinea pigs, are setting the stage for the nearly 100 men and women entering the program this fall.
The community calls this our medical school. The whole community is proud of TCMC.